subtopic in your book, which is force between two parallel wires. Okay, two infinite parallel wires are there. You need to find the force between them. Okay, let's try to derive the expression for it. Okay, we'll treat it like a numerical. We'll not treat it like some formula. Suppose these are the currents I1 and I2. Okay? The distance between the two wires is, say, distance is A. Okay? In your book, they have taken D. Let's take a D. Find out the force. And by the way, the previous question. We found out force on the smaller wire due to the bigger wire. What about force on the bigger wire due to the smaller?
Going to be the same.
The same in opposite direction. Okay? Newton third law. Here also, even though I am trying to find force on 2 due to 1, on 1 due to 2 will be same in opposite direction.
So okay? The expression should be similar to 2.
Ha, you can say that. If wires are similar,
sir, we find force per unit length.
Direction of force, first tell me that. On to second wire due to the first wire. Direction of force is?
Magnetic
field is there. On to the second wire due to the first wire. Magnetic field is? Into the what? Into the what is magnetic field? Due to first wire, the magnetic field is like this.
They attract the.
It is into the what? Okay? So B is like this. So I L cross B will be the force. Force is I L cross B. Can you tell me L cross B direction is where? B is into the what? This is L. So L cross B?
They'll attract each other.
Left.
L cross B.
Left.
Left. So, this is the force on the second wire due to the first wire. So, on the first wire due to the second wire, it is like this. So, they are attracting each other. So, it's an attractive force.
This is, you have to find per unit.
Now, we will be using this formula onto the second wire. Alright? So, magnetic field onto the second wire due to the first wire. This is how much? Mu naught I by
2 pi.
2 pi A, mu naught I1.
2 pi D.
Okay?
D.
So the force, since length and magnetic field are perpendicular, cross product is just simple multiplication over here. So it will be mu naught I1, I2. 2 pi D into the length. Now if length is infinite, the force is also infinite. So, it makes sense to find out force per unit length. Okay, just an application of whatever we know already. So, nothing new. Okay. So, force per unit length is this. If two currents are going in the same direction, they will attract. If they are going in opposite direction, they will repel each other. Okay, so remember these basic things. Okay. Understood this? Okay? So this you can treat like a numerical, a sort of numerical. We move to next. Okay. Next is torque on the current loop. Till now we are talking about force only. First time we are now talking about torque due to the magnetic field. Okay? Alright? Torque on a current loop. Loop is what? Magnetic dipole moment. In a way, I am trying to find torque on a dipole moment. Okay? Just like in electrostatic, we found torque on an electrostatic dipole moment. but as P crossing. So something like that I am trying to find out here. Okay. Now, best example of a loop in a magnetic field is AC or DC generator. Loop is there that rotates between the two common magnet. Okay. Actually, what happens, the number of turns becomes so much that the loop becomes very heavy. So rather than rotating loop, they are rotating magnet itself. Okay. But then we'll assume loop is only rotating. So let me draw the diagram here. Copy this.
Huh? No.
any loop, net force on any loop. We can prove it later on, right now please write down. Net force on any current carrying loop in a uniform magnetic field. In a uniform magnetic field, will be zero. It does not matter shape of the loop. It would be any random shape. It need not be even in 2D. Okay, if it is a loop, net force is zero. Okay, now what about torque? Let's try to find. Torque because of A to B about center of mass is how much?
Energy cross B.
Force into? The force is into the plane like this. This force into its distance from this axis, which is how much?
L1 by 2.
Right? So torque because of A into B is IB L2 into L1 by 2. Okay? And torque C to D is what?
IB
L2 L1 by 2, same. So they will add up or subtract?
Add up.
It will add up, they are both trying to rotate in the same direction. This force is getting in, this is coming out. So both are trying to rotate it same direction. Okay? So they will add up. So total torque is IB L1 L2. Okay, what is our assumption here? The loop is rectangular. L1 L2 is the area. L1 L2 is area. So this will become current into area into magnetic field. Torque. Current into area is magnetic dipole moment, magnitude. M into B. Yes or no? Okay, now you will realize one thing that it also depends on how loop is oriented. Okay, torque will be zero if the loop is like this. If loop is like this, magnetic field is like that. What is the force on this? If current is going down, what is the force on this? Which direction the force will be?
Down.
If current is down, magnetic field is like this, the force will be like that. Like this. Like that. Okay? So only force over here will be like this. So it will be stretching it. Okay? And if you reverse the direction of current, it will be compressing it. But it will not be able to rotate because the force is passing through the center mass axis. Okay? So it depends on the orientation of the loop also. And it so happens that if area is perpendicular to the magnetic field, the torque is maximum, which is right now. Otherwise, a factor of sine theta will come in. You have to take component of force, F cos theta, F sine theta. F cos theta will pass through the axis, torque is zero. Only torque is because of F sine theta. So like this, if you do, a factor of sine theta will come in. Okay? And if you take it like a vector equation, torque will be equal to M cross B. Okay? So, we have derived the torque in terms of magnetic dipole moment. Now, does it matter that whether there is a loop or something else of dipole moment M placed there, it will experience the same torque?
So why is it M cross B and not B cross B?
Just a matter of convention. Okay? Why it is M cross B, why not B cross M? It's just the way, you know, just the way the directions are. The force in this way and force in that way, they try to rotate in such a way that this is true, not B cross M. There is no physical reason to it. There's a mathematical reason. The way, you know, we assume the force to be and the way we find the torque and we assign direction to the torque, the way we assign direction to torque using right hand rule. If all that you take into account, it will come out to be M cross B. No physical reason. Okay? So this is a torque. Now, does it matter that whether there is a loop of dipole So we have generalized it. The dipole moment is a basic component of magnetic field, right? But anyway, we will be trying to prove that, right? Similar way of derivation can be done for any kind of loop. Okay?